right, it's January 26th, 2013. I've already done the test run of this part to be sure everything was going to work out okay. Hopefully that stays the case. See anything, can you? Well, it's face milling. You'll have to take my word for it until I can get up on the observation. Until I can make a mess here. There we go. It's milling the face flat here first. Boy, if I need to hit the emergency stop button, I'm not in a good position to do that for sure. So I gave up on recording video of the part while it was being cut simply because there was too much coolant on the screen here. So instead we're looking at the finished part. The chamfers are complete. They're looking very nice. In addition to the chamfers, there was, let me start over from the beginning. Rough the outside, rough the inside, rough the hole. And I finished the outside, finished the inside, and then finished the hole. Then after that, I did a chamfer on these four faces that remained. So that's it. That's the whole part. All right. Even though the coolant is difficult to see through and so it's getting a little frustrating to try to video this, I decided to do it anyway because this will be the first attempt I've made at waterline roughing. So it's facing off the top of the part right now. This is the other side of the part that I just finished. Once it's done roughing the top of the surface, the top of the part, it will do some sort of bulk roughing operation, I suppose you could call it, to get the general shape of the paper. And then it'll come back in 25,000 steps. And do the actual waterline roughing operation. Get the general shape of the part first. I believe this will make it in three steps. You can see that there's a little bit of a terrace already. And it should finish this at the same diameter that it's running right now. Thank you. should start the waterline roughing. The first batch of operations is going to have two cuts. Make two circuits around. That's the first one. Here's the second one. I'm running at 48 inches a minute here. So the taper is starting to show up pretty distinctly at this point. The general shape of the car. And now I'm going to switch tools, and then that will actually give me the opportunity to finish the outside diameter of the part.